was always for.
It's funny how you might know something like that, but not really know it. I couldn't tell if the mountains used to always be there. I could have sworn I used to drive at night because I didn't want the sunset to blind me. But wouldn't the mountains have covered that? The way the hills would roll forever, little buildings jutting up at random peaks and valleys. Was it always that way?
My beloved Charlotte, the woman that had become as much a part of me as I was of myself. She had always been ravenous in studying the ancient texts left of the Eldritch gods. I didn't understand what she told me about her studies, but I supported her as best I could. And then, one day, she began to talk of such things as saving our realm from the incoming evil and being infested by an approaching darkness. I woke the next morning and she was gone. A note left to me only contained the words, "I have been banished to the ancient realm. It is for the best." Distraught and searching for anything I could do to bring her back, I sought the help of a miser high in the mountains. He showed me but one hope, a torn scrap of ancient text describing the process of recapturing the essence of a loved one from the dark pits of that shadowy place. Torn and ragged, it was written in an Eldritch language long forgotten by our culture, known only to those who had contact with the Eldritch gods themselves. I snatched the scrap from the old man and brought it to the great library. I thought I could use the texts written there to decode the alphabet of the ancient language, so I could know the secrets written on the scrap of paper and bring her back to me. In the library, then, is where my story begins. There's my first clue. I should jot that down. Infested? Could this have been this? I think he took something. Charlotte, the woman I love. She stood before me exactly as I remembered her. No longer did she have a beast inside her. The ancient split had given her back. I grabbed her hand and led her outside the library. We stood together in the moonlight. No words were shared with each other, but no words were needed. All was right. My beloved Charlotte, and that in the library, then, is where my story begins. In a moment, the ritual was completed. But something was wrong. Charlotte appeared in front of me, but I saw so clearly that she was not who I remembered her to be. There was a beast inside her, something horrible, dark. Nyarlathotep had taken form in my love, and I had unleashed it back into the world. With a cry of horror, I hid my face, but it was no use. Nyarlathotep enveloped me, using my soul to fill the gap that was left in the ancient realm. There was nothing to stop Nyarlathotep from destroying our realm. Darkness enshrouded the human world. I had brought about the new reign of the ancient gods.